Moving on to the mechatronic body parts, these are the limbs I'm wearing. Each limb has 3 computers and 24 sensors. There's feedbacks that emulate lost muscle function. This restores capability in people not only for flat surfaces but very rough terrain. This is a person with bilateral amputation. We're also building exoskeletons to augment capability, not just to bring people up to normal levels. So here's a person that suffered a stroke, and here's an exoskeleton that restores capability. In the future, again, we'll achieve this with light. So here he's walking with a drought foot pathology, and then with an attached robot, we can mitigate disability, create symmetry between left and right sides and whatnot. In the realm of augmentation, this is the first exoskeleton that was ever built that augments human walking. So this person does not have any limb disability whatsoever. He has completely normal natural legs. This is a synthetic calf muscle, enabling him to walk and run at faster speeds and lower metabolic energies. It's so profound in its augmentation that when you wear it for just 20 minutes, your own normal biological legs feel heavy and awkward. So I think in the future, when you walk down the streets of Dubai, you'll routinely see people wearing robots because they go faster, they want to be stronger, they want to protect their biological joints from high stresses. So I'll finish up with regenerative body parts. This is the work of Bob Langer at MIT and his many colleagues. This is a mouse where the spinal cord has been cut, and of course you see significant paralysis in the hind limbs. What Bob's team have done is built a polymer scaffold, injected that scaffold with neural stem cells, and they then promote regrowth of the broken spinal cord. So you see here, after 90 days of regeneration of the spinal cord, a significant return of motor function in the hind limbs. What's very exciting is this recently went to a human trial. The FDA, however, did not allow for the neural stem cells, only for the polymer scaffold, but the pilot data are still very compelling. This gentleman would have been completely paralyzed by the waist, from the waist down, and now he has bowel function, he has basic walking patterns. So I think in 2 decades, we can largely solve paralysis by doing 2 things. One, repairing the spinal cord the best we can using regenerative medicine. And then secondly, using the digital nervous system that I described earlier, using light from muscles to mitigate or eliminate the remaining pathology. So I'll finish up with a comment on new identities. So